Hello, 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 hello. My new and my old subscribers, how are you all doing? God bless you all richly. In the name of Jesus, I love you all that is passing by, that is something up, something down. I love you. God bless you all richly. In the name of Jesus, how are you all doing, my old and new subscribers? I know you're good because if God be for you and I can be against us. Nobody, we are coming as strong daily to the glory of the Lord. In this channel, we do everything to encourage to the glory of the Lord. You see my music, you see everything here. To the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah. Today I'm going to be talking to you that is disappointed with God. Yes, that is disappointed with God. Why are you disappointed with God? Why are you disappointed with God? God has sent you, will not leave you. Why do you feel that God leaves you and he sent you, he leaves you? Why? God can never leave you. If God sent you, stop complaining. Because he that sent you know that you are capable of doing it. Why are you telling God, why me? God, I'm so disappointed. Why me? Me that is a stammerer. Me that don't know how to read. Me that is a prostitute. Me that is armed robber. Me that is all. Me that is this. Me that is that. Me that cannot read. Me that is not outspoken. Me that cannot speak English. Me that cannot read. Me that cannot understand well. Me that people cannot accept. I don't think people will accept me. God, I am not the one you're supposed to send. I'm so disappointed. I don't want this. God, don't send me this. God that sent you know you are capable. And God that sent you will back you up. Don't be disappointed that you are not too special. I'm not too special. Why would God send me? People that are special are there. People that go to school are there. People that go to university are there. People that can read and write are there. Why is God sending me? God knows that you are capable. He knows that you are capable. Because if God did not know that you are capable, he will not send you. If God does not know that you are capable, he will not send you. And don't be disappointed that God, you are the one that showed me this marriage. You said this marriage is so good. And now, why am I waiting for the fruit of the woman and not getting it? God, you say this job is good. Why is it that I'm receiving all this kind of trouble, all this kind of situation, all these kind of things here in this office? Is it God that gave the dream to Joseph? God is the one that gave the dream to Joseph, you remember. But the brothers have to make the dream come to pass. So why are you disappointed in God? Because God showed you that office. When you go to that office will make you great. And you are there because of the scandal, because of the things you are receiving there. Now you are not disappointed. Why did God show you what is not real? No, God is not a liar. He can never show you what he don't want you to do. When he sent you, he will back you up. He will back you up. He will back you up. Don't be disappointed. Don't say, no, God, you said I should go to this place and preach the gospel. And there, they are not accepting me. I'm so disappointed. God, are you sure you are the one that showed me? I am so disappointed. I'm so discouraged. Are you sure you are the one that showed me, sent me? Why is these people not accepting me? Why is these people pushing me away? Why is these people causing trouble to me? Why is these people throwing stone and there? Why is evil everywhere? What is happening? I am so disappointed. I wish I know I could have come to this place. If God sent you, is watching over you. That is what I want you to know today. If God sent you, is watching over you. You should not be disappointed in God anytime, any day. Because if he sent you, he will disappoint you. He will never disappoint you. Stop complaining. God, you show me this church to worship. But I'm here. They are throwing a lot of stone. People are jealous of me. People are doing a lot of things. Have you seen a tree that has no fruit? People looking for that tree. Have you seen that? Have you seen a tree that is not bearing fruit? People want to eat something from that fruit. No, it's because you are special. God knows the speciality that is in you. That's why he sent you. He knows that you carry something. That's why he sent you. Don't close that church. Don't close that ministry. Don't close that business. Don't quit that marriage. If God is the one that sent you, he will back you up. Sometimes you can struggle to be there. Sometimes you can cry to be there. But I'm here to encourage you today. Don't be disappointed in God. There are a lot of messages. There are a lot of things that God can send you. But the things you are receiving there, the things that you are passing through there, the kind of stone you are taking there, the kind of humiliation you are taking there, you want to question God, are you sure you are the one that sent me? I am so disappointed. Why would you send me and not back me up? God says he's with you. He said he's with you. Sometimes we are even disappointed. God, we worship you every day. We praise you every day. Why is the country like this? Why are they fighting? Why is one prayer not putting the evil ones down? What is happening? God is seeing everything. He said he will wash over us. He will wash over us. I don't want you to feel disappointed in serving God anytime, any day. Because he's with us. He will never leave us nor forsake us. There are some certain things that will come. But that time, you have to hold him strong. You have to hold him strong. Because he has never failed before. He will never start it in your life right now. He will never start it in your life. Do you see Abraham? Do you know how many years Abraham waits? There is no time that Abraham said, God, I'm so disappointed in you. Look at this. Look at that. No, Abraham did not say that. Abraham continued to still be praising God, to still be worshiping God. Look at stranger Meshach and Abednego. When they threw them inside the fire, they could have said, God, what is happening? We have been spreading your good news. We have been doing that. They want to throw us into the fire. For stranger and Meshach, so be complaining. Did you know they start praising God? They start praising God. They start singing. They start glorifying him. They start glorifying God. What did God send you that you are disappointed? That you feel that, I wish you know you could have answered this call. I wish you know you could have answered this. I don't know it's the road is so stressed like this. I don't know this thing is so stressed like this. I don't know why this thing is going like this. I don't know what is happening. I am tired. But God says, I should tell you today that you should hold him strong. He sent you. He is with you. He is watching over you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Don't murmur. Because the time you murmur, that is the time you stumble. Do you know that Moses, when Moses was talking to Pharaoh, when Moses take the children of God away, when they are going to the promised land, Moses supposed to know that God that has been leading them will lead them. No, Moses was angry. He used the rod. He said, oh, Moses stretched the rod. He smashed the rod. Because why? What is happening? We have waited enough. Why is this thing not going? Why is this river not parting? He smashed it. Because he was angry. What are you angry about now? I've been in the church every day. I praise you. I serve you. I sow a lot of seed. I do a lot of things. Why is this sickness not going? Are you sure you are with me? I'm so disappointed. I don't think I want to serve God anymore. I don't think I want to do this anymore. It's like it's a scam. It's not a scam. It's washing over you. Sometimes our head wants to bring a lot of things to us. Sometimes our thoughts want to bring a lot of things to us. But that time we will have to hold God strong because he will never leave you nor forsake you. Sometimes you want to doubt. You want to doubt. You want to start querying God. You want to start questioning God. God, what is happening? I'm serving you. I'm doing everything. Why is this trouble coming? I didn't look for this trouble. I didn't do this. Or maybe you'll see people that is not praying, that is not going to church, that is not doing anything. They are just living life. But you are living a life full of drugs. You take drugs every day. You're sick. You're not healthy. You're looking for the fruit of the womb. You see somebody that dances his way to club, drinking alcohol, doing a lot of things, and just having the babies. But you want to start doubting God. God, are you sure? Are you sure? Remember, he said a fool saying his heart that there is no God. Are you sure this God that says that God is alive, is it not a scam? You want to doubt God? It's not a scam. He said he will never leave you nor forsake you. It may tarry. I want you to hold him. In the word of God in Nahum, he said God is a stronghold in the days of trouble. He said, wait. If you faint not, you will reap in due season. He said, if you faint not, you will reap in due season. Hallelujah. I want you to keep on holding to God. Don't be disappointed. Oh my God, the time I was in the world, the time I was clubbing, the time I was drinking, the time I was laughing, my life was better than this. Why is it that the time I accepted God, now a lot of trouble starts, a lot of storms start, a lot of tribulation start? That is not what I heard. That I heard that when I come to God, everything will be so sweet. Everything will be so lovely. God, I'm so disappointed. It's like I have to go back to where I'm coming from. No. No. He knows what you are passing through. He knows those people that is bullying you. He knows that your trouble that you are fighting. He knows everything. He knows. Remember, he never promised you that you will never see tribulation. He said, 1,000 will fall at your right hand side and 10,000 at the other of your side. He said, but they will never come near you. He said, you should always say that is the Lord, your strength all the time. He says he has given his angel charge over you. There is no time, he said, there is no trouble. He said, but you will tread on serpents and scorpions. He said, nothing shall by any means hurt you. You see those things you are walking through. You see those things that you are passing through. That is the serpent. That is the scorpion that you are treading on. You will soon come out of it. Daniel did not do anything when they planned against him for the king to throw him in the lion's den. But Daniel is supposed to say, God, why? He did not say, God, why? But God take care of Daniel in his own way. Who knows if Daniel had fear in his heart, but God take care of him in his own way. What is that tribulation? What is that trouble? What is that thing that you are facing, that you are feeling that is like God is no longer with me? It's like God is disappointing me. No, God is not disappointing you. He said, we never leave you nor forsake you. That is a deceit from the devil. That is a lie from the devil for you to quit what you are doing, for you to weak in the faith, for you to start, go back to where you are going to, coming from. Don't do that. He's with you. He's with you. Don't quit that job. Don't quit that ministry. Don't stop that choir singing to God. Don't stop that church. Don't stop pastoring. Don't stop evangelism. Don't stop doing those things that you are doing. If God sent you, he will back you up. You might be passing through some. You know what is it? Is that what is the problem with us? Is that we just want everything to be sweet all the time. Yes, it's good for everything to be sweet. It's good for everything to be sweet. But there are sometimes God wants to see how strong is your faith. God wants to see how strong is your faith. Remember that God was in the boat with his disciples. Jesus was in the boat with his disciples. But when the storm come, Master, God wanted them to use their own faith, to use their own power too. There are some things that God wants you to speak it out. For God wants you to, God know that when he sent you, deposited power in you, he wants you to fight your way out. He wants you to fight your way out. For instance, that is my son, that is my daughter, but you are murmuring. You are losing hope in God. You are disappointed in God. You are complaining. From today, I encourage you to stop complaining and start moving. Start moving. When Joseph had a dream, his brothers, when they threw Joseph out and sold Joseph out, Joseph supposed to say, I don't want to believe in Jesus anymore. I don't want to believe in God anymore. Why will he give me a dream that will kill me? But it was a dream that led him to his own destiny. What is that dream that God gives to you? And you are struggling with it. You are struggling with it. Everything is like as if it's not working. You are about to quit. You are blaming God. Don't go back to your vomit. God is with you. He will make everything beautiful in his own time. Wait. It may tarry. Wait. Hold him strong, because he said, if you faint not, in due season, you will reap. Later, their brothers has to go to him and see that the dream that God gave to him still come to pass. Hallelujah. Don't be disappointed in God. I know if you want to cry, there are times for you to cry. It doesn't matter. You can cry. Sometimes you can ask him questions. Yes, it's not bad. Sometimes we are human. Sometimes you may want to ask God, what is it? You are doing everything right. You read it in the Bible. If you pay your tithe, everything will be good. You sow seed, you do that. You feel you want to do everything that you saw in the Bible. You want to live right. You don't want to offend anybody. You don't want to do anything that will offend God. But things are just going wrong with you. You work hard and work and work and work and work and work and work, no reward. You walk like elephant, you eat like an ant. You are saying, God, what? You are the one that sent me. Why are you punishing me? He's not punishing you. The time is going to turn your story around. You will be like them that dream. If there is no test, there is no testimony. If there is no test, there is no testimony. God is with you. Hold him strong in the days of trouble. If you have complained before, you have murmured before, don't run away from him. It's just for you to go back and say, God, have mercy. Have mercy upon me, O God. Forgive me my sin because my faith wanted to faint. Forgive me my sin because I complain and murmur. God, have mercy. Have mercy. I trust you in everything. You are my source of strength. You are everything to me. Even though things are not going right now, even though things are not going well now, it's just my imagination. God, have mercy. Have mercy. He will have mercy and take you back. God is not a liar. He said, when you turn away from your sin, he will forgive you. So when you turn, you have complained, when you turn and say, have mercy, God could have forgiven you. He will forgive you. Come back and start doing those things that you are doing. Yes, I know. I know. God sent you, he put a ministry in your hand. He put a job in your hands. He put marriage, and things are not going another way. It's normal to complain. It's normal sometimes to say, God, why? But you must go back and say, God, have mercy. It was just my meditation. It was just my thought. My head was full. I thought maybe you send me to a wrong place, and God can never send you to a wrong place. Remember what he said. The devil wants to attack. What God said, that is what the devil wants to attack. You carry a great blessing. God see you and sent you. And the devil see, he wants to destroy. And why will you allow him to destroy? Because of your memory. God is so faithful. And the center of it all is you that I see. Is you that I see. At the center of it all, it's you that I see, it's you that I see, oh, there is power in your name, thank you Jesus, miracles happen in your name, oh, as you lift your hands to worship you. It's you that I see. It's you that I see. Thank you, Jesus. You are not a man, oh. You are not a man, oh. You are the God who was and is to come, oh Lord. You are not a man, oh. You are not a man. You are the God of heaven and hell, no one like you. Thank you, Jesus. Hold him strong. He will never leave you nor forsake you. He's the mighty God, the I am that I am, the lion of the valley. I pray for you these days. You are blessed. May God bless your going out and your coming in the name of Jesus. Your favor, anything you do is blessed in the name of Jesus. May God continue to give you strength to go. Strength to go. Strength to move. Strength to do that. I reject the spirit of murmuring in your life. The spirit of complaint. You continue to go higher, higher. May his grace continue to speak and work for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, everlasting Father, for answering our prayer today to Christ our Lord. Amen. Before we meet again, keep on basking in the Lord. Keep on rejoicing. No matter how far you are gone, just go back to him and say, God, forgive me for quitting what you sent me. He will back you up. He will accept you back. And may his name be praised forever in the name of Jesus. Bye-bye.